Hello, hello, hello. Good afternoon, good afternoon, good afternoon. It is I, I'm Ben. Once again back, and this time I'm here to help you. Yes, that's right, you. For I know that with all this coronavirus malarkey going on, you're doubtless self-isolating, and I suspect you're saying to yourself, "Do you know what? I'm playing Puzzle Combat. I really wish that I was part of a very active, fun-loving alliance, which would help me to keep myself occupied whilst I'm self-isolating." Well, look no further, my friends. Canada Dry are recruiting, so this is my alliance. Well, it's not my alliance, it's actually Juxtaposed Camel's alliance. He's world famous. He was the first winner of a legendary challenge event. He won the first challenge event and came, I believe, second or third on the last one. So an extremely good player there at the top of our team. So one of the sort of greats currently in Puzzle Combat is there. We're a good fun-loving alliance. Lots of advice offered freely. We have 25 members at the moment. We won our last war. We're hitting war machines like this one at the moment, which we will be defeating, which is a 7 stars. Sometimes we go up to 8 stars. We've beaten a couple of 8 stars. If you look at us, we've got plenty of chat. So, you know, if you're self-isolated and you're thinking to yourself, "Oh my goodness me, I'd like to have I'll have a bit more time to play Puzzle Combat and take part in the games." And see how all of that goes. Well, then, you know, this could be the alliance for you. And we've got 5 spaces at the moment. Minimum trophy requirement of 1,000 trophies. And we are looking for sort of good active players. Our rules are pretty much we expect you to hit the war machine, and we expect you to use or try to use all of your flags in alliance wars. That's sort of a fairly standard thing for top alliances. We can make allowances for like players who've got what do we call it? Who've got real life commitments and so on and so forth, like everybody else. And we do, that's it really. And I would say for anybody who hasn't already worked this one out, is Alliance Wars, the lowest you can score is 0. So the lowest you can get is nothing. You can't actually lose points by attacking. So even if you're using your unleveled food heroes, now I'm quite lucky because I've got a lot of 3 stars that are leveled up. But you know, if I was absolutely out, then I could do it. A team of Aidens and Chens, completely unleveled, I might only score 1 point, but 1 point is better than no points. So it's worth just chucking in your food heroes anyway. You can't. There's nothing to lose by trying to attack. So I would always say that for anybody in an alliance. And obviously, as I'm in this alliance as well, there's sort of random bits of advice that I offer, as well as some of the other good, really strong players in this alliance. We do sort of support each other quite a lot. So. That's my shameless alliance plug. I thought I'd chuck that one in there. Like I say, 5 spaces available. The other bit of this video I was going to do just quickly was to show you the zombie horde, because the zombie horde's been made quite a bit harder. It was always tricky, but they've sort of upgraded it now, so that it is quite a lot tougher than it used to be. I am going to be taking. I'm just going to swap my team around a little bit. So I will have. Da, 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 da. Flint, do-do-do-do-do. Now you may be thinking, why have I put Flint next to Rana? But basically, it's because I want to keep both of them alive. So Rana keeps Flint alive, and Flint keeps the riposte going. Although actually, this time I am going to swap it around a little bit and just spread my rebounders, my counter attackers, and put Dougal in the middle, because Dougal will also heal everyone. Dougal, of course, has the advantage that he heals everyone and adds armor, which can be really important. Now, because I know from previous experience that this can be quite a tough battle, I will be taking some battle items to help me out. So I'm going to take some bandages because they're very, very cheap. Nothing to be, nothing. Don't overlook them when you're doing this kind of quest, because you know they're cheap. They're free, or more or less free. So you know they don't cost much in the way of food. I will take chronoblasters, and I will take no, not life force accelerator. Sorry, I will take some flame bombs to just set everyone on fire if needs be. Overall, the zombies, as far as I can tell, there's no point in color stacking because you just get who you get. I've got to change that. I still ticked as my defense team, and now I've changed it around again, and I don't want to do that. But there we go. One, there's a point there. Just watch which team is your defense team. So here we go. Standard sort of thing. You'll see how tough the zombies are. I mean, look at the damage that zombie at the center there has soaked up. What's his name? Roberto. But although in this being just as he is a zombie, he doesn't actually have a name, like he's just, I think he's civilian zombies. Oh, no, he's down as Roberto. Oh, they've given them names. They used to be just, like, you know, civilian zombie and soldier zombie and whatever else, but apparently now they are all deserving of an actual name. You'll see, so this is where I'm talking about the damage is really kicking in. So I'm going to get Rana and... what's his name? Dougal's going off. Rana's going off. And Flint is going off. So now my whole team is perfectly riposting or rebounding or counterattacking, whatever you want to call it. So the zombies can sort of more or less kill themselves for a little bit. You'll see how tough they are. I mean, this one at the middle, how many tiles are we hitting with, including, you know, green tiles, red tiles, you name it. They've all plowed into him with joyous abandon, and he's still standing. There we are, first zombie killed. Gives you some idea of quite how ridiculously tough the zombies are now. They were always, you know, relatively strong, but now they are majorly strong. This is one of those ones where Boomer really comes into his own there. You saw how much damage he did. Really useful, because he does hit everyone, even the million and one zombies that are on the screen. I'm going to try this. Let's see, get a little combo going. Flint is charged up. I'm going to use the bandages on Thrasher just to keep him going. This is where bandages are wonderfully cheap, but, you know, it will keep him going. I'm trying not to use my more expensive battle items because, well, they're more expensive. So I'm going for the cheap ones, but I may yet need to resort to using some of the better ones. And kind of keeping this guy, what's his name, Dougal, going. Just trying to keep the overall health of my team reasonably high because ideally I don't want to lose anyone just yet. In a moment, I may chuck in a flame bomb. I'm sure chronoblasters were the right ones to take here, in fairness. I might have been better off with something else, but not quite sure what at the moment. It's a slow screen as well, mind you. Then every tile is going to hit somebody, so there's no generating mana. Let's see. Thrasher can go off here. I am going to chuck in a flame bomb. Let's just get them burning a little bit, because it will just... See, the flame bomb, obviously, again, it's a bit like... Boomer, I mentioned earlier on, Boomer's really good because he then hits everyone, and so does the flame bomb, which is really quite a valuable attack. So we've got, Rana's going to need a few of these things. Yeah, I think actually, looking at it, the chronoblaster was a bit of a mistake because these guys don't have mana, do they? Oh well, let's see. Let's see how we get on. Let's see, this hopefully will get Dougal ready, which will keep him alive at least for a bit. Or at least keep everyone alive for a little bit. So the zombie numbers are back up again. As you can see, the screen's nearly full of zombies. The perfect riposte is doing... I keep calling it perfect riposte in this game. Of course, it's called counterattack. Doing a fair amount of damage to them. I'm normally targeting the zombie in the middle because a lot of the heroes hit like one person and everyone around them, which, given that that kind of counts... Normally, because the zombies are in like a massive scatter, it does actually count quite a lot of zombies in each hit, which is quite nice. As ever, looking for sort of combos on the screen and what have you, always a good idea. Just to keep the screen moving, keep the zombies dying. Those are the sort of key aims of it all. You'll see there he did a load of damage. Boomer's really good for this, actually, because he does do quite a lot of damage to everyone. This will get my Dougal ready again. That's a nice little combo rolling on there. Rana can go off. Rana helps keep everyone alive. And here we go. Go straight down the line. My Thrasher, I know Thrasher's a 5-star, but it's worth bearing in mind that my Thrasher is he's not leveled up. Because I don't have any... Oh, I've got one wrist computer, so I need about another... I need another one before I can level him up again at all. So he's a bit stuck at the minute, which is majorly frustrating, but there we go, can't have it all. Bum, 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 bum. Guns going off. You'll see now the zombies are on the ropes here, really. They're down to 7 zombies overall. The damage is going in a bit more than it was. There we go. So I've got a reasonable shot of finishing them off. There's one more zombie to come onto the screen. Looking at the bar at the top, so it says 6 zombies left. There are 6 zombies on the screen, so once these guys start dying, that's it. The odds are now decidedly looking like in my favour. Dougal has done a very good job of keeping most of my team alive. You'll see, yeah, though, so like I say, I mean, my aim here has been to do it as cheaply as possible. So currently, I will have used, I may need to use one more battle item, I'm not sure. But currently, I've only used one flame bomb. And then the other items are all, you know, the really cheap ones, your minor mana potion, your minor charge drinks, your bandages, and yeah, one flame bomb. The rest of it's very cheap battle items. So sort of scrape my way through it. I made a mistake with the chrono blasters. I wouldn't actually recommend them for this. You're probably better off with like a shock grenade. The shock grenades are very good. They also lower the defense of your opponents, which is really, really useful against zombies. Whereas actually the chrono blaster just slows down, is most useful for heroes that generate mana. So that's normally the bosses. But none of the zombies in this actually do generate mana, so it doesn't matter so much, really. There we are. So there's one zombie left, and I've still got a full team of heroes alive, so it's not looking very good for her. Yeah. Now, the sort of big add-in to the zombies, which wasn't originally in the game but got added in, is you get the zombie summons as well, and you've got 100 zombie once you're up to 200 zombies killed, you get to claim some zombie badges. I've seen it deliver me 15. Normally it just gives you 10. So we go into here, we press the zombie badge button, let's see what we get. Food, iron, metal, gold, 10 zombie badges. Yeah, so I have had 15 zombie badges on one occasion, and let's see whether I get what's his name? Manfred or Roberto, because those are the only two zombies I ever appear to be able to summon. Yeah, 75%. Well, I'm due an epic one. More than due an epic one. I don't know how many I've done now, but it must be 8 or 9, I think, because I've certainly had 8 or 9 Robertos and Manfreds. So let's see whether I get Roberto or Manfred this time. Ah, Roberto, there we go. There we are. 10, or I should have, I didn't count them, I should have done, really. However many zombie summons I've done, all I ever get is Roberto and Manfred, anyway, not that I'm bitter, not that I'm grumbling, but there we go. So one day, maybe one day, I will actually get a zombie that is useful. Spud and Lindsay are two of the best heroes in the game. They drive me, they're so frustrating to fight against in raids and things. And I can't get either of them, which is driving me absolutely mad. I don't even know if you can you buy zombie tokens, possibly. Can you buy them? No, you don't seem to be able to buy zombie tokens. Maybe you can buy them somewhere, I don't know. I mean, not that I'm spending money. I am largely free to play. Well, at the moment, I would argue I'm totally free to play, although I did buy, when I started playing the game, I bought two, I think it was two, possibly three VIP passes. I think it was two. Basically, just to get my training camps up to level 20 as quickly as possible, because level 20 training camps are where I've got my 5 stars from, because anybody who's ever watched my Empires and Puzzles videos will know that I have no luck with summoning. As was shown by that zombie summons then. 75% chance to get a 3-star hero, and 25%, roughly speaking, to get an epic zombie. So that's 1 in 4. So having done, I think, 8 or 9 summons, I should, in theory, have got 2 4-star zombies, whereas, in fact, I have none. All I ever get is Manfred and Roberto, and I'm fed up with it. But there we go. Let's not dwell on my frustrations. Let's move forward and carry on. So it just remains for me to say thank you for watching. Remember to like and subscribe to the video. Remember that if you are looking for an alliance, Canada Dry are recruiting. As we've sort of mentioned before, you don't need to be Canadian, and you don't need to be dry either. We're quite happy with people who are wet, which sounds yes, perhaps best not dwell on that one and go too deep into that. Other thing is we may well be changing. We're talking about changing our alliance name to make it clear that we aren't just Canadian and make it more inclusive. I mean, you can tell it's not just Canadian by my own accent, but there we go. The options are there. So anyway, thank you very much for watching. It has been deeply, deeply emotional. And yes, may death come swiftly to your enemies. This is Farmer Ben saying goodbye. Take care of yourselves, look after yourselves, and come and join a powerful alliance. Take care. Bye.